From the potential capabilities of manipulating DNA to the irresponsible mistakes that can occur, today we look at the truth about CRISPR and gene editing. Number 9. CRISPR Unraveled. Associated recently with the concept of gene editing, the term CRISPR actually stands for Clustered Regularly Interspaced Short Palindromic Repeats. What this refers to specifically are the DNA sequences found in bacteria that act as an immune system. This DNA holds on to the bits of invading viruses that bacteria has already eradicated. The Cas9 enzymes produced by the bacteria to fight viruses will use these stored bits to identify past infiltrators and dispose of them quickly. For years, this information was simply a scientific discovery useful to microbiologists. But what researchers found later quickly changed that forever. Number 8. Revolutionary advancement. In 2011, two researchers were enamored by the CRISPR process and the Cas9 enzymes and began examining them in detail. The University of California Berkeley's Jennifer Doudna and Umea University's Emmanuel Charpentier wanted to know how exactly the Cas9 enzymes chose what viruses to chop up and store and when to do so. In their experiments, they found they could actually fool the bacteria's CRISPR and Cas9 enzymes and give it artificial RNA. From here, the Cas9 proteins would store that information upon shredding the RNA and use the stored data to attack anything with the same genetic code. So a year later, the team of scientists released a paper detailing their work and the conclusion that they could, in a way, cut up any genome anywhere they want. The discovery was mind-blowing to the genetic research community. It wasn't long until inspired scientists like Feng Zhang of the Broad Institute and George Church of Harvard would discover new uses for this discovery, like the editing of human cells. Not only would they be able to remove harmful genes with the Cas9 protein, but replace them with beneficial ones as well. And it does so at a low cost and incredible precision, advancing gene editing in multiple ways. Number 7. Beneficial uses. The discovery of what CRISPR can control and do has sent minds racing, and some of the potential advancements that could come from using their enzymes are world-changing. For example, scientists have had a map of the human genome since 2003, but understanding and identifying what each gene does continues to elude geneticists. But CRISPR will allow scientists to figure out what each gene does by systematically removing them and noting the resulting effect. That's only the beginning, though. Using CRISPR, scientists could complete such feats as creating more nutritious and even tastier crops. Farmers could herd hornless dairy cows. Peanuts could be harvested sans allergens. Even fruits themselves could have their immunity strengthened to survive fungal diseases or other afflictions. CRISPR could also be used to take out genetic diseases and even be used to remove HIV infections. It could also be used to exterminate bacteria more effectively as they build stronger and stronger resistance to antibiotics. Animals that carry potentially dangerous diseases or they themselves prove to be too lethal could be altered for the better with CRISPR. And then there's babies. While they can have their DNA edited by CRISPR to be resistant to diseases and viruses, the other side of this coin holds implications far more sinister. Number 6. Ethical dilemmas. While the benefits of being able to eradicate genes that might cause harm to a baby later in life sound grand, there are negative implications that come with the power to edit your newborn's DNA. Scientists are far off from being able to recognize and alter genes that would, for instance, reliably raise your child's intelligence. They have yet to identify even the most dire of threats to children in terms of their gene pool, let alone enhance specific characteristics. As far as the science community at large is concerned, there is not enough known about using CRISPR on the human genome to guarantee a safe result or even a beneficial one. But this doesn't mean attempts can't be made. CRISPR technology is relatively inexpensive, and because of that, experiments can be conducted fairly easily, no matter how rebellious to scientific wisdom they may be. In the past, genetically modified organisms or GMOs have raised public suspicion due to a lack of transparency, thus creating public distrust. The geneticists behind the advancement of CRISPR have hoped to avoid the same issue. But irresponsible procedures like those performed by one Chinese researcher in particular put those hopes in jeopardy. Number 5. Unnecessary experiment. In November of 2018, the global scientific community was rattled with the news that He Junkui, a scientific genetic researcher from China, had performed the first CRISPR edit on babies, a pair of twin girls named Nana and Lulu. He described his experiment in person at the Second International Summit on Human Genome Editing, held at the University of Hong Kong, and immediately drew the ire of fellow scientists, including the CRISPR trailblazer Jennifer Doudna. In her response, Doudna said, "I feel deeply disappointed that the technology was used in the way that he described, as well as a bit horrified, honestly. Firstly, the aim of his experiment was misguided. He and his team intended to remove a gene used by HIV viruses to enter human cells once the HIV virus was contracted. The only problem was that while their father may have been HIV positive, the twins didn't have the virus. And even if they did, there were already safer proven treatments that could have done the same thing. To make matters worse, he allegedly didn't edit the genes correctly, or even completely. Instead, new mutations seem to have appeared in their genetic code. Even the details of his experiment, which were only revealed to a select few at the Hong Kong summit, were said to have been amateurish by other scientists. Number 4. Unintended consequences. While he may have had good intentions, the results of whose work are far from successful. Two of the three mutations introduced to Nina and Lula changed their CCR5 gene, the one targeted in association with HIV, significantly. The results of such mutations could alter how they work, and the outcome of their mutation is something that will need to be studied. Normally, this kind of experiment should have been performed on lab animals before moving on to human subjects, at which point consenting adults afflicted with HIV could sign up for the experimental procedure. But WHO catapulted over these logical steps, instead implanting the CRISPR-edited genes into the embryos of a woman. This wasn't the only ethically questionable part of WHO's experiment, though. In order to find a patient for this project, WHO utilized an AIDS association to find potential subjects under the guise of an AIDS vaccine development project. The scientist claims to have gotten the consent of the individuals in question. However, taking consent was a skill that WHO was unqualified to perform, thus calling the validity of their consent into question. The consent form used for his patients is even problematic, as the wording is overly technical and unclear of any dangers or controversies surrounding the project. Instead, it focuses more on securing the protection of WHO and his team from any legal blowback, as well as the right to use photos of the patients for advertising purposes. Number 3. Saving face. As if predicting the backlash he'd receive for such a project, WHO took certain steps prior to conceal his work. His own school, the Southern University of Science and Technology, were never informed of his ambitions, and in order to keep his work unassociated with the college, he took unpaid time off to begin his pursuit. The renegade researcher does claim, however, to have received ethical approval from Shenzhen Harmonic Care Hospital. The hospital's medical ethics committee, however, disputes this statement, going on to clarify that the signatures on WHO's supposed approval form are suspect to have been forged. In hopes of combating the condemnation received by contemporaries, WHO organized a PR campaign to clear his name. WHO crafted a series of 5 videos for YouTube in which the scientist elaborates on his motivations and logic behind the experiment, essentially trying to give the public his side of things. The videos themselves have gained some traction, with one of the videos specifically, the clip made concerning the twins Lulu and Nina, achieving more than 400,000 views online. Though a mixed reception in the comments section reveals WHO Jun Kuei still has many more minds to sway. Number 2. On the take. The news of WHO Jun Kuei's experiment shocked most everyone in the science community, though there were some with knowledge of the rogue scientist's intent before his unveiling to the world. WHO had made his field of study known through various scientific conferences where he had shared gene editing research in other animals, but secretly he would share his true endeavors with only a select few scientists. This included his former advisor, Rice University's Michael Deem, who participated actively with the gene editing product, going so far as to have been present during patient consenting. That would be the extent of support that he could garner, though, as most other scientists and researchers weren't nearly as encouraging. When attempting to seek advice from experts like Matthew Porteous and Stephen Quake of Stanford and Mark DeWitt of UC Berkeley, the response was unanimously disapproving. Chided for his naivete in regards to the ethical implications, he was told by all three not to go through with the project. To counteract such blatant acts of ethical defiance in the science community, David Baltimore, chair of the Hong Kong Summit on Genome Editing, has called for a see-something, say-something policy among scientists. While no single international group oversees the ethical use of gene editing, countries do have their own means to regulate the procedures, like China's Medical Ethics Agency. Number 1. Scientific aftermath. Since news of WHO's experiment hit the public, various scientists, including Fang Zhang of the Board Institute, have called for similar experiments to be temporarily prohibited. Originally, the Hong Kong summit released a statement with a fairly lax connotation, but a second statement came out following the summit's conclusion, calling WHO Jun Kuei's supposed experiment irresponsible and the results deeply disturbing. However, the summit and similarly minded scientists still believe genome editing is the future, with the summit going on to say, "The organizing committee concludes that the scientific understanding and technical requirements for clinical practice remain too uncertain and the risks too great to permit clinical trials of germline editing at this time." Progress over the last 3 years and the discussions at the current summit, however, suggest that it is time to define a rigorous, responsible translational pathway towards such trials.